Welcome everyone to my channel. Today we are making soup powder. This is going to be for your vegetable soup or spinach soup, any kind of soup. So just to add a little bit of flavor to your soup, and we also make it like a kuttu. In our language, it's like a vegetable squash, and we add this powder. So this is any time powder. So once you make it, it is good to go, and you don't have to keep making it every day in a busy schedule like all of you have. So I make it like Priya, and I keep it for more than 3 to 4 weeks, depending on how big you make it. And you can always double the recipe or lower the recipe according to your needs. If you like to make it fresh on a weekly basis, that's good to go too. So first of all, let me show you the ingredients. I have a sesame oil. This recipe works great when you use the sesame oil instead of dry roasting it. We are going to add a little bit, so when you finally make it, it adds flavor. Now sesame oil is very healthy for digestion as well, so it has a healing property if you have any infections or inflammation in your gut or in any part of the body. So we use sesame oil just to heal our gut. So that being said, the next one is the cumin seed, and I have the peppercorn, I have the urad dal, coriander seeds, chilies, and the last one is the coconut powder. But if you have a dry coconut, you can always cut it and then we can add it to that recipe as well. But I didn't have that, and I wanted to make this recipe very simple and easy, so I am just using the shredded coconut from the store with no sulfites. That's one thing to watch out for, no sulfites. In this recipe, we are just going to add a little bit of maybe a teaspoon of sesame oil. And the first thing that I'm going to do is fry my red chilies. We have to do everything separate in this recipe so it doesn't mix, and because everything has a different roasting point. So I'm just going to fry it for like 20 seconds until it's medium brown. You can really have that smell of the sesame oil coming out, and it is a very healthy smell. And my pan is in medium hot. You never want to do it low heat because it won't cook, and you don't want to do it like a high heat because it's gonna burn. As you can see, our red chili is brown and really dry. So it is done. I'm just going to transfer into my plate. And then the next thing that goes is our urad dal. One thing to keep in mind is the urad dal and the coriander seeds have to be the same measurement. So that's how this recipe works great. I'm just going to fry it until it is medium brown. Alright, my urad dal is well roasted and it is medium brown. And I'm going to take a pan like that, and I'm going to put it in so it can cool down. And the next thing is we are going to add a little bit of oil, and I'm going to fry my coriander and cumin seeds. First the coriander. Once it is a little roasted, we will add the cumin and then the peppercorns. Alright, our coriander seeds are very well done. Now how do I know if it is done or not? It depends on the size. It gets larger in size and also it pops like a popcorn. Now it's time to add our cumin seeds. How do we know if the cumin seeds are done or the peppers are done? You will know with the smell, the aroma that it goes around, and also the little bit of the fried smell, but not burnt smell. So we have to never leave the stove. We have to keep stirring it like this and sauteing it, because this can really go into flames in minutes. So we just have to keep sauteing it like that and keep frying it. You're dry roasting it, but keep roasting it. I say fry because I add a little bit of oil, but this is a completely dry roasting right now. And it is done. And I'm going to pour it into my container over here, my pan. And the last thing that we need to do is fry our coconut. But very carefully, we have to do it on a light brown, because we don't want it to be burnt, and it will be burnt very soon. So we have to make sure it is on low heat right now. I have turned my stove on to low heat. And now I am roasting it. You don't need any oil for this. So it's just making sure that the pan is not going to get too hot. And I'm going to turn off my stove because it is becoming a little brown right now. So this can work with the heat already in the stove if it is electric. If it is gas, you may need to work a little bit. This is a very easy recipe. Once you try to make it on a weekend or something, you can pretty much have it for 3 or 4 weeks depending on your need. And because it has coconut is high in omega-3 as well, so that yields a lot of benefits as well. So my coconut is also done. I'm going to put this in, and we are going to let it cool down for like 30 minutes before we do the well grind, and I'm going to show you guys how. Alright, here is our soup powder or kudu pudi, and I have grinded like a coarse kind of grind. I didn't do a very powdery, then again it's going to get thick when we use it in the hot soup. So this is just like that. You can do like a really coarse or a dry coarse as well. So I have done that dry coarse. So I'm going to pour it in into this plate over here, because this is going to stick to the surface and it is a little warm right now even though we waited for 30 minutes. So I'm just going to spread it around like this in this plate, so that way it can cool down faster. And once it is cooled down, I'm going to store it in my airtight glass container so that can last for 3 to 4 weeks. So if you like this video, please do subscribe, and I'll come back with more videos.